here, like in the few moments available to me, I want to firstly agree fully with every line of Minister Shatter's speech. And in my agreement, I will therefore not refer to any points made. I think he summed up my views on the issue, and I thank him for his leadership in this regard. I want also to acknowledge the work of the Constitutional Convention and say from this House that I believe that the Convention has a solid future, notwithstanding the current narrow remit. And I'd ask government to extend it, perhaps even on a permanent basis. But my concern this evening is the operation and planning for the referendum. I believe that low turnout in referendums is a major cause for concern, and we need to review radically the way we do referendums. Any future referendums must be carefully planned and orchestrated. The recent result of the Shannon referendum should be examined in detail to consider why people voted as they did and why most people, 60%, didn't even bother voting at all. So qualitative research on this topic is vital, as we need to determine how opinions were formed on the subject matter, how these views were changed or confirmed during the course of a campaign. We need to know how and why a majority in favour 4 weeks before the campaign became a minority on the day. Factors such as popularity or otherwise of the government, the communication of the message, the motivation of the voter, all affect the turnout. And we need to obtain hard data on voter behaviour before we go to the polls again. Recent limited research underlines the need for a publicity campaign to be carried out over a much longer period of time, the information or publicity to be transmitted in different ways than through the referendum commission, and the campaign should be broadened way beyond the narrow party political elite that we've seen in recent referendums. So without detailed voter research, we're left with speculation by pundits and armchair experts, which makes for great political entertainment and postmortems, but is of little of no scientific value. And if the Department of the Environment or government doesn't conduct the research itself, well, then I suggest that a sum of money may be made available to academia or political scientists. Ask them to do the job, because I think it's crucially important. And the second point I wish to make is aspects of the ludicrous McKenna and Coughlin Supreme Court judgments need to be addressed. The requirement for the government to adhere to a 50-50 broadcast rule is bizarre, represents a subversion of democracy. It undermines the democratic mandate of TDs, both sides of the House. We've heard everybody from all political parties speak in favour of a recommendation in the referendum, yet we know that when it comes to the campaign, this can't happen due to the McKenna and Coughlin judgment. The results, this results in the electorate becoming confused, the electorate are unclear on the questions that are being put to them and the issue under scrutiny. While I very much favour equality, very much favour same-sex marriage, I acknowledge and I say that much preparatory work needs to be undertaken. The government introduced a topic and the government isn't allowed to campaign actively in the manner in which they might for a yes vote because of legal constraints. So I think as legislators, we need to get on with this. We need to exercise great care. I look forward to a positive campaign, a vigorous campaign, but a campaign based on fact, not on fiction.
Thank you very much indeed. Next to speak is Deputy Buttimer, Deputy of 3.5 minutes.
And I want to welcome and congratulate the Minister on his pioneering initiative and to salute the men and women in our public gallery from Marriage Equality, Glen, and the Irish Council of Civil Liberties who have given us leadership in this debate in terms of civic society. The extraordinary transformation in our country in the 20-year period is culminating with the report tonight before the House of the Constitutional Convention and of the referendum to be held in 2015. We have moved as a country where being gay and lesbian was being seen in the context of shame, where those of us who are gay or who are lesbians were seen as being criminal in the eyes of our state. Many of our fellow citizens had to emigrate, had to leave their own homes to go abroad or to migrate to Dublin or Cork to create their own communities because of the shame and because of the burden placed upon them. Thankfully, because of the leadership, and I stress again, of Glen, Marriage Equality and Irish Council of Liberties and all political parties in this House and others, we have moved to where we're now on the cusp, on the threshold of a referendum where equality will be given to all of our citizens. The only area where I, as a gay man, is not equal is in my constitution. And that is with the ability to be able to get married. And hopefully, in 2015, the Irish people will give that transformation the next movement, where we will be all equal, cherished equally under our constitution. We've seen a huge journey, Cahir, like a remarkable one, and I'm very proud as a member of the Constitutional Convention of the mature debate we had at that particular weekend. And I also want to congratulate the experts, people like Ger Durkin and other experts who gave of their time, senior counsels, people who came in to make presentations, whatever the argument was. And this debate tonight here is the beginning of the referendum campaign. And it's very clear that this referendum campaign will be about marriage under the eyes of our constitution. As the minister said, it won't be about religion, it won't be about anything else, it'll be about marriage. And the pictures of civil partnership, Cathaoirleach, look, across our country show men and women from all types of society embracing their love, urban and rural, young and old, and the world hasn't fallen down. The same values, the same love, the same affection, the same commitment exists no matter who we are. And that's why those pictures, those images, celebrate love, which we all cherish in our lives. The next step is that referendum. In April, we had a fantastic debate in our Constitutional Convention, where over a two-day period, we heard a magnificent debate and presentations from everybody. The debate took place, people thought about what they had to say, and they thought about how they voted. 79% voted for the right to have a referendum. I hope, Cathaoirleach, that in the lifetime of this Gael, that we will see a plurality of the Irish people voting to support the recommendation from government to hold a referendum on marriage equality. I very much welcome the statements by Taoiseach that he supports marriage equality for lesbian and gay couples and that he will campaign for it. I salute the Fine Gael members of our parliamentary party and our members across the country, and in particular Minister Shatter, who has been supportive from the word go. This is about people, and I conclude in this. This is about people. This is about the love that we all have.